nobody else. I don't wanna work nobody else. But I guess I wait. Oh yeah.
You're listening to WWE Real 1100 AM, and we want you to practice good hygiene by simply washing your hands. So enjoy 20 seconds of blinding lights by The Weeknd as you practice.
He said you're not going anywhere, sweetheart. That's what I told him. That was a birthday gift. He said he ain't going nowhere.
I wouldn't be happy to get some roses.
Remember to stay connected to The Real and stay really safe. Have just entered the building with your boys, King and Sane. Welcome to Shop Talking Random-ish, where conversation rules the nation and no topic is off limits.
You know, this ain't nothing but healthy conversation.
Now welcome your hosts, Rick King and Will Sane.
Greetings, Atlanta, America, worldwide internet. Thank you for tuning in to WWE 1100 AM, The Real. You're on Shop Talking Randomish with King Insane and the lovely Starlight. I am Will Sane.
It's your boy Rick Kang. I am in the building. I am on the boards. I am dancing.
He's so much.
Jam it. I am.
I am so extra.
That too.
I am. What's and then, good? And then we got the lovely Starlight. How you doing, Miss Starlight?
How are you? How are you? I'm here, everybody. I'm here.
Glad to have you. We got the super producer, Greg, in the building. Greg, say what's up to the good people.
Big Shug.
Yo.
Y'all know what this is. This ain't never some good old-fashioned barbershop-style conversation in this young barbershop. No conversation is taboo. We ain't got but one rule and one rule only. Will, what is that rule?
That rule is say what you mean what you say. Just don't be mean when you say it. Starlight, please tell the people what to do if they want to be a part of the show.
If you would like to call in, the number is 404-603-8770. Or
if you're in your mammy basement, please let her know it's not one of them 9-1-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9-9- But every now and then it does get a little freaky dicky in this hymn box. But not tonight. Please let her know that the call is on us. You can hit us at 1-888-926-7562. You can also find us right now. I'm talking about right now on Talking Random Ish. That's T-A-L-K, the comma up top.
Apostrophe.
N. Random Ish Facebook page. You can find us live right now on T-A-L-K, comma up top.
Apostrophe.
N. Random Ish Facebook page. You can also catch us on Apple Podcasts. You can also find us on Google Podcasts. You can also find us on Spotify Podcasts. And I think you can also find us right now on Amazon Podcasts. But y'all know what time it is. Y'all know how we do. Y'all know what we about to do. The shop is now open. My people, good people, my people, what is good? What is good? How are you doing this evening?
Life, love, and happiness, brother. I'm good, bro.
Where you get that from? You bought some of that?
No, bro.
What they said that?
Hey, you know what? Hey, whatever. You know what, man?
Huh?
We here.
Yeah, I know, right?
Okay.
I'm just happy today.
Okay.
I'm just happy today. You know, I'm putting a positive spin on my week. So I'm putting a positive spin on my week.
Okay.
So I'm happy today.
That's great.
I want you to positively.
Yay, me.
I see you positively wearing that hat, huh?
Hey, you know what?
Hey, we finna talk about that. We got another business to talk about.
This is a part of my turnaround week, man. It's turning my week around, bro.
With that hat?
Yeah, I'm turning my whole week around, man.
Okay.
Good things are gonna come my way.
Okay.
Yeah.
Falcons win is gonna come this Sunday. Dogs win is gonna come this Saturday.
Okay.
I'm just like, man, it's all gonna happen.
I mean, one out of two ain't bad.
The Braves won.
Shout out to the Braves.
Hey. It's been what, 20, almost 20 years, right?
Almost 20 years since we got out of the first round.
Yeah.
19 years.
Hey, you know, and I'm not trying to put a damper on anything, but man, the only thing I do hate is when we win this championship, I don't want to hear anybody say that we only win it when it's a abbreviated season. That's the one thing I don't want to hear anybody say.
I don't. I'm not gonna give a damn what they say.
Yeah,
yeah. That's what I'm saying.
A W is a W.
Let's take this championship, and so I don't want to hear anybody
who
say that. Oh, it was just a. Well, it's because they only played, you know, 60 something games or.
As bad as our pitching started out being.
Oh yeah, we got bad pitching.
As great as our pitching has been in the playoffs.
Yes, it has.
Well, we 5-0 in the playoffs.
Undefeated.
Playoffs. And 4 shutouts.
Yes.
Am I right on that? Great. Am I right?
Four shutouts.
It has been.
I know it's been at least three.
Three shutouts.
Yeah.
Okay, three shutouts. Yeah. Y'all.
Those bats coming alive, man, and that pitching is doing.
And the crazy thing is, our main bats hadn't been the total catalyst for us winning.
It's been everybody.
Everybody.
Yep, it's been everybody. Team effort.
Yep.
Team effort.
Wait, what was the score of game three? Was it 7-0?
The last game? Yeah.
I thought it was four shutouts. Yeah.
Nobody scoring on us.
Yeah.
Dang.
Yeah.
Good job, Braves.
Good job, Bravo. Good job, Bravo.
That's what I'm talking about. Marietta Braves. Keep it up.
Hey, Cal County Braves. Let's do it. Let's get it. Hey, y'all, we got family back in the building.
Yes, we do.
We got the man.
The will man, be. The legend. Soon to be.
Soon to be.
Sheriff of DeKalb County.
Mr. Harold Dennis.
Speaking into existence. Come on.
How you doing, family? How are you?
Glad to have you, Mr. Man.
And he got his beautiful queen with him.
Yes.
How you do, ma'am?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm doing good. We are here. We're going to get into what we here to talk about. But, earlier voting starts next week. Tuesday to be exact. I want to make sure I'm 1,000% correct on that.
Yes.
So that's why we here. We here to talk about why in the hell are we voting?
Mm-hmm.
Why do we need to get out and vote? Mm-hmm. That's the main topic for tonight. But before we get to that topic, I think we got a pretty good mixture of men and women in here tonight.
Yep.
First of all, I got to ask one question. My homeboy, my cousin, on Facebook, he posted a question. Derek Huff, my cousin, he posted a question on Facebook. And the question was, does men deserve to be romanced?
Does men? First of all, I'm going to need him to rephrase that.
He didn't say education.
I don't answer those questions.
So that's the problem with y'all on social media. Y'all are the grammar.
Grammar police, man.
That's the issue y'all have.
That's the first thing. I gotta figure out your question first. I gotta figure out what.
Do men deserve romance? And my first question is, I want men because we got men in the room.
Do men deserve to be romanced?
Yes.
Okay. Now. So everybody else, I want to go. Will, do you think you deserve to be romanced?
Yes, I do. Okay. I'm a sensitive guy.
Harold, do you? You are sensitive.
I am sensitive.
I am finding out you are a very sensitive young man.
Very sensitive.
Harold, do you deserve to be romanced?
Of course I do, sir.
Lady.
Yes, men deserve romance.
Absolutely.
Greg, we know you're a little sensitive. Do you deserve to be romanced?
What's that supposed to mean?
I mean, you got to put your foot up in the shower.
This is why you can't tell. You can't tell your wife to friends. Stuff out there.
That's what they do, friend. We gonna keep coming. It probably go next year. We gonna have a show, and they just gonna hit me. Hey, Greg, dude, you deserve to be romanced.
Greg better shut down the whole show.
No, you see it. Look,
Greg, stop the whole.
Come on, don't do it, Shug. Don't do it, Shug.
No one else.
Just turn off Rick's camera, Greg. No, turn off nobody else's camera but Rick's camera, Greg.
He's not here. He's just a floating head.
And y'all wonder why I call him Shug. Y'all wonder why we call him Shug.
Greg, you want to be romance?
Just move on.
You want to be romance, Greg?
I'm not answering the question.
Greg, say I don't want to be
romance. I think we need to elaborate on that question.
Okay, no. My second part.
She wants you to be. We got a guest in the house.
Y'all didn't ask me.
Do you feel like you should be romanced?
Once I figure out what the hell the definition of romance.
Okay, so now she said that. She said that she.
Yes.
That
now
we need to
back
elaborate.
To what you were saying.
Please. What are you doing?
Uh huh.
What's your?
Well, I would like to elaborate and basically, what are you doing at home that you think that you deserve to be romanced?
Okay.
So you think. So in what you're saying is, you only get romance if you deserving of romance.
Absolutely, it's earned.
Okay, now, okay, let's. What is romance? What is ooh. And I'm gonna start off with Big Shug. What is your definition of romance?
Communication is part of it.
Good answer. People think good that, answer.
Hey, you know good I need answer. To make a, you know I need yeah. to make a sound to say good answer.
You got Family Feud.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Communication is part of it. Uh-huh. A lot of people just think it's like doing.
No, things, I don't want. I want your.
But yeah. For me, it's communication.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Well, my definition is romance starts way before intimacy. Okay. So romance can start way before the bedroom.
Okay. 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 Starlight.
All right. The definition of
definition.
Webster.
I didn't ask you. I'm not asking Webster.
Here come the teacher. Here come the teacher.
One, a feeling of excitement and mystery associated with love. And two, a quality or feeling of mystery, excitement, and remoteness from everyday life. And I agree with both of those statements.
No. Before you did that, what is
your definition, but not without going off of that? What
being
is
being made to feel special?
Okay.
Mr. Harold, what is your definition?
My definition of romance is holding hands, looking at yourself, looking at your spouse in her eyes, and just enjoying life with a nice glass of wine.
Okay. Will?
Wooing the person. Does everyone say wooing the person?
Okay.
But that means like finding out, having that conversation first to figure out who the person is. And once you figure out who the person is, you find out how to romance them, how to get those feelings tingling inside of them, and vice versa, them getting that back from you. And I think that once you romance someone, it also makes you feel good about yourself. And so it's like you sort of get that reciprocation at that time as well, and then that person can feed your soul as long as you're feeding them
and
their soul as well.
In the,
so
yeah. Definition as a verb.
Oh, it
the
is.
Definition says to woo.
Look at me. Course. I didn't even know that. I didn't even. Good answer.
Good answer. Good answer.
Good me. What you say, Rick? What about you? What's romance to you, bro?
Learning the person that you're with.
Mm-hmm.
Romancing them to me is doing something unexpected that you know that they will enjoy and they like.
Yeah.
And at any given moment, I don't care, just giving them a piece of it at any time. Yeah, that's my definition. Now, men, I'm strictly talking to the men right now. What would be your ideal romantic?
What would I want somebody to do for me?
Yeah. If you could walk it when you leave the radio station right now, she hadn't listened to the station.
She's from
Russia.
Yeah.
Russia got any black women?
Yeah. I don't know.
Yes.
Do they? I've never seen one.
Well, a few. I mean, like four.
Have you seen one?
Maybe five.
Will, you found the only black girl in Russia.
Okay.
And she at your house, so she ain't listening to none of this because she don't understand it.
Yeah.
When you get home,
what would you like
for her to have? Would make you feel?
I'm gonna tell you what's romantic to me, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, one is two things. One, if somebody gives me a gift and unexpected gift. But they listened to something I said, and then they gave me that gift out of something I said. Mm-hmm. Like we were just having a random conversation, and she just heard something.
So we're talking about love languages now?
Well, I think that's part of romance to me. Because
that's considered a love language, receiving gifts.
Well, gifts isn't. But hold on, let me say that though. Gift isn't my love language though.
Oh.
So see, understand? I don't care about gifts. I'm gonna be honest with y'all. I don't care about gifts.
It's more the
but if somebody give me a gift and it's something that's out of something that I talked about. I spoke about it, and I'm like, yo, you give it to me?
Attention.
That's part of romance to me. And the other part of romance to me is, this is my love language, is touch. So if I'm chilling with somebody, right,
mm-hmm.
and she's just, like, on me, and she's, like, touching me, and she's, like, letting me know that, yo, you my guy, and I'm your girl, to me, that's romance to me. That's romance. I like all that other stuff, like, don't give me no petals and no champagnes and no Rolex watches or no sneakers or nothing like that. That ain't romance to me. Like,
hey, well, tell her she can send me the Rolex.
Yeah.
Tell her send me, and I'll wear 10 and a half.
You can have it. You can have
10 and a half in shoes.
That's not me. That's not me.
Harold.
Well, what's romance to me is. Okay, can you hear me now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What's romance to me is, like Will said, I love to touch. I love the touch of my wife, to touch me, to look at me in my eyes, and just cuddle. A lot of real men don't know what cuddling is, but cuddling is really nice. It's very romantic.
Hold on. Now, I seen the definition of cuddling is when you have one hand on the breast, the other hand in her panties. Yeah. Is that we in the barbershop. We talking. We're in the barbershop.
More like spooning.
Spoon.
Yeah. I'm going to tell you, I'm with you on that, bro. I'm going to cuddle. I'm going to cuddle all day, bro. I'm going to tell you. If a woman don't cuddle, I can't be with her.
They
got to
go.
Hey,
they got to go.
If you complain about my body temperature too hot, you need to go.
You got about 5 minutes. You got about five good.
Nah, bro. I'm all night cuddling. Where you going? Who you trying to go see? Get back over here.
Cuddling,
okay. Nah, we cuddling all night.
No. You got about 5 to 7 minutes cuddling. About 5 to 7.
Nah.
Greg, if you were leaving right now and walk, what would make you feel like?
I would want to, I guess, feel like I was, there was some kind of anticipation for me showing up, and now, like all is well, or like something like I missed you, or I, you know, I'm happy to see you. I'm happy that you're home. I guess just to feel like, okay, this is where I should be. Yeah. So I can feel like, okay, this is where I should be. And this, I can look forward to seeing that person.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
If that makes sense at all.
Yeah.
So what about you, sir?
Oh,
his first definition of cuddling.
Oh, Lord.
Romance sex. Just moaning. How do I spell romance? S-E-S.
I'm simple. I am so simple.
Sex is simple. S-E-S. Romance.
I'm simple. Like you say, having my drink, if you know my favorite drink, having my drink fixed. When I get there, I'm a music head. Some nice music. Hell, sitting in the chair next to me watching a movie. Mm-hmm. You know, just it's nothing. It doesn't have to be anything extravagant. I'm so simple. I am so simple, and it's just like that little, very little ish.
Yeah.
That does it for me.
Do y'all want to be wooed? Like, should she have to take y'all out to dinner and everything? Should she, I mean, like, do you like that when she takes you out to dinner and she says, hey, babe, dress up. I'm taking you out tonight.
And she really pay?
Well, actually, my wife is an excellent cook.
Yes,
so,
I am.
I'm very spoiled. I'm probably one of the last few men in
we do
Atlanta.
Take samples. Okay, we do take samples.
My wife actually brings me dinner in bed.
Yes, I did.
Word?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Dinner, breakfast, lunch.
Well, what the heck?
Dang.
Well, what the, relationship goals? Goals.
I gotta record that.
Hey. Goals.
Okay, so you know, I'm gonna say that now. On that, then that must mean you're a good dude, because I'm gonna tell you right now, I know plenty of women who will say I would do that if the man was deserving of it and if the man acted quote unquote like a man. Now that's the part I don't understand. What's, that like a what's
like a man.
Man.
Yeah, yeah. So we ain't gonna get into that tonight, because okay, we gotta talk not, politics. That's a whole
female. What's like a man?
No. Let's
female. Come on, we got another female over here.
Let's get into it.
Come on.
Let's get into it.
Are you gonna bring me out?
Yes, we're gonna bring you out here. Come on.
Let's get into
all
it.
Female participation as possible. Yeah, as much as possible. Really? What is acting like a man?
Define acting like a man.
I want to hear the women first.
Yes. Yes.
Come on.
I get it.
Greg can make this happen. Greg.
Hey.
Hey, come on.
How are you?
You look nice. You know, you didn't even know you were going to be on camera. You looking all nice. Come on. You didn't even know you were going to be here.
No, my definition about, come on with the question one more time.
Okay. First of all, what is a man? What is acting like a man? I hear the comment all the time is a man needs to act. I want a man who acts like a man. What's acting like a man?
There's a couple parts to this.
Okay.
First part is like old school. Men pay all the bills. Men, you know, step up, you know. But there's a new version of acting like a man. Mm-hmm. It entails the old version, but there's some additions to it. Just know your woman. You know what I mean? Act like a man. Step up to the plate.
Yeah.
So she won't have to struggle. You know what I mean? Do your part.
Yeah.
You do exhaust all your measures to find some kind of way. If something popped off, have a backup plan. Mm-hmm. Just make her feel secure. Make her know that you got her back any case scenario.
Okay.
And just make it happen. Come on with the jokes. Just make it happen.
Just make it happen.
That's all I got to say.
Well, for me, when you say act like a man, if you're truly a man, you don't have to act. You don't have to say a word. If you're at home and you're howling home, you don't have to act. She knows. You don't have to open your mouth.
So true.
You know, okay, is this an age thing? Oh, hold on. We're going to get back to that point. Starlight.
Honestly, I agree with both, but really it's just if you are of a certain age that we look at age-wise as someone reaching like adulthood and man or womanhood, then there's things that go with that. If you claim you are a man or a woman, but you're doing things of like a child and still wanting to be taken care of and spoiled, well, like not spoiled, but more so like you're rotten with it. No, that's not. But like if it's in you, if you really are a man, if a male is a man, like she said, it's not an act at all. Like, you see it. It's one of the things you can't turn it off.
Yeah.
So it's like everybody around you see it. Everybody knows it. Like, you walk in and it's just there.
Now I'm going to say this. I think I'm a man, but when I get sick, I turn it off. I'm going to tell you right now. It's turned off.
We kind of expect that from y'all.
Okay.
That we kind of expect that when a man is sick, that it's just like, all right, he's a baby again.
Yeah.
But
I got to ask you, Sheriff. Do you be the baby when you get sick?
Absolutely.
I plead the fifth.
So is that when you get the food in the bed?
I plead the fifth.
1, 2, 3.
I have no recollection. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fifth.
But I think that a lot of quote unquote independent women.
Yes.
Have a issue with stepping aside and allowing a man to be a man.
You know, I've heard. I've heard that.
Hey, you hear
so? I had a conversation, and I was told that, okay, a woman is going to submit to a man who leads, and my thing is like, okay, but that's have to be willing to submit.
Let's have a conversation. Hold on. We finna go to break. And when we come from break, I want to have a conversation about this word submit.
I got you.
I want to have a heartfelt conversation.
Yeah, everybody know that we're supposed to do early voting on Tuesday. So
we gotta go get the wine.
But we done got something else right now.
Is really supposed to be here.
Now he brought his wife in the building, so now conversation changed.
But
hold on the conversation.
I want to have a real conversation about submitting. And if we can find, while we on break, because we're going to go through a song.
Starlight's going to find it.
No, I want to find the actual definition.
Starlight's going to find it. Starlight's going to find it. She's a teacher.
I also want to go through the Bible, because there's some biblical. I want to tap into all this.
Do we want the King three James main texts? Do we want the Bible version, the Quran version, and the Torah version?
Nah, and I want Puffy. I want Puffy mix. I want
no. I'm
Pete
saying
Rock's mix.
We can have the three main religions version of this word. We can have the actual definition. Of
only if you're gonna pull up Buddha. You gonna pull up Buddha's too?
I don't think Buddha has a submit type of thing.
I mean, I want to because
Buddhism is different. It's written differently.
We don't have one.
Oh, now so today you are?
I'm Buddhist today.
Okay, okay.
He typically falls more towards Buddhism.
Who's ever winning?
But yes, but like I said, when we come back, I really want to have a great, because that word causes a lot of friction.
Yes.
And I want to have a conversation. And I for real, we going to talk about getting out and voting early.
Y'all know to do it. It's the right thing to do.
Y'all know why.
Even if we spend the last 5 minutes saying get out to vote early,
exactly.
You know to get out to vote early. And you better vote for Harold Dennis. If
DeKalb County Sheriff.
I was about to say, my bad.
DeKalb County Sheriff. If you want DeKalb County
to be ran correctly, if you want that sheriff department to be ran correctly, please vote for the black man sitting next to me right here. And I ain't saying just because he's black. But a lot of y'all are black over there in DeKalb
County. But see, the beautiful thing is, but see, let me tell you why this is beautiful. Because who he's running against is also black.
Absolutely.
So you can't say we just vote for him because he's black.
The platform.
We vote for the right black person.
That's it. We get right. We vote. The reason why he's here and the reason why we like him be because we feel he's the best candidate, regardless of what gang he represents.
And it's not about sexism. It ain't because he's a male either.
No, but when we come back, we're going to hit this submissive conversation. We will be right back.
You are tuned into WWE Lakeville, AM 1100.
The opinions expressed during the sponsored programs on this station are strictly those of the program hosts, guests, and callers and are not necessarily those of Beasley Broadcast Group, this station, its staff, other advertisers, or agencies.
Yeah. I ain't your average rapper residing in Calabasas, mashing the Aston through Malagasy and Madagascar. I don't believe in your white Jesus and Last Suppers. I place value on brothers who never had justice. I am the black savage, Ollie informing and Zaya fighting for black magic. Rifles and flak jackets, mama was suicidal, papa had bad habits, product of true survival. Rocking like Black Sabbath, hopping about the Chevy, Pac Biggie Machiavelli, OG like Nas or Reggie, culture like Oxenbelly, Vogue like Akinelli, focus like Dr. Sebi. We did it your way, but now the culture is bopping to our Sinatra medley. I'm limitless energy, they gimmicks and imagery. Kendrick Cole and the Kennedys, lyrical holy trinity. General of the city, they end up promoting silly beef. Keeping it willy deep, Wheezy only a milli beat. Dream chasing, facing the enemy like in the meat. Tyler Perry writing my winning speech like it's Emmy week. Heart of gold, never sold my soul, Glock weighs a ton. Hov telling Lori Harvey no with Rock Nation brunch.
One life to live, just don't settle. Life, I'ma live forever. Stand for something, fall for nothing, no. Rest in peace, the dead, that's on my soul. You only die once and then you go. Who know we be fighting all alone? Who don't know the rights from the wrong? Truth goes to the light behind
how
it
how much
all.
More do you want? You wanna send us back to where we came from? Cause we just savages. Well, here's my kiss, yeah, yeah. I made a gold mine, and I go back home, I'm a gold mine, and we taking all the land back, they stole mine, and cause what you reap now is what you sold mine, and I wear your soul, my goddamn.
One life to live, just don't settle. One life, I'ma live forever. Stand for something, fall for nothing, no. Rest in peace, the dead, that's on my soul. You only die once and then you go. Who know we be fighting all alone? Who don't know the rights from the wrong? Truth comes to the light behind it all.
If I rule the world, I would go return all of the gold that was stole. Reupholster the nose on the Sphinx, it's a war, huh? They trying to take the soul out of soul. Need to say I sold out, I never sold out a show. Even though people drove out in droves, plus a whole lot of hoes, I suppose. On the road to success, you gotta pay the toll, I was told. I don't hang with pawns, I'm Genghis Khan. Slang with a gang of cons that came with guns, who speak the language from the ancient ones. Dangerous, huh? We shining, digging, shame the sun. Do I move D or stay a Saint Laurent? Cause y'all fashion week in the Saint Milan. Calusa to your Juan Ponce de Leon. Make sure it's peppercorn sauce on my filet mignon, my nigga.
One life to live, just don't settle. One life, I'ma live forever. Stand for something, fall for nothing, no. Rest in peace, the dead, that's on my soul. You only die once and then you go. Who know we be fighting all alone? Who don't know the rights from the wrong? Truth comes to the light behind it.
My fervent action raise my hands up alone with my antenna. Cynical, we born sinner. Killer, cause we want dental. Try to warn in them, but keep on growing. Try to stay away from foreign. Better recognize when the devil show his horns. He enjoying his horns like Donna Goins. It's the difference between yourn and Tamika and Lauren. Young Warren Buffett in his prime, you ain't even knowing. How she pulled to get thick, you just be feeding her corn. With your corny every day, fraud, why she fucking on your head, you know. Go to jail, tell it all before you ask for your attorney, yeah. But you can never be me. Knew who I was before I got out the trap to sell a CD. I've been shoulder to shoulder with gangsta facing LAPD. Felony after felony, still to be yelling me free. Now my philosophy is no possession, no apostrophe. Cause ain't no use in being in prison, you ain't got to be. Ironically, we died the crazy with Harper with Hammer. Just how they used the dog, and we hit with braids and bandana. Man, it been more mad killing than the days in the year. One day fighting for it, worth it much of leaving it here. I'm saying.
One life to live, just don't say. One life, I'ma live forever. Stand for something, fall for nothing, no. Rest in peace, the dead that's on my soul. You only die once and then you go. Who thought we'd be fighting all alone? Who don't know the rights from the wrongs? Truth comes to the light behind it all.
Welcome back to Shop Talking Randomish with King Insane and the lovely Starlight. I am Will Sane.
It's your boy Rick Kang. I am in the building. I am on the boards. I am behind the glass. I am.
And it is your girl, the lovely Starlight.
We got Greg in the building. Greg, say what's up.
Big Shug.
Yo.
And who else do we have?
We got DeKalb County Sheriff candidate Harold Dennis in the building.
Dennis is in the house. How are you?
We have his lovely wife, and I'm terrible with names. Please say your name one more time.
Sabrina.
Sabrina. Most of us are. Sabrina. Most of us. Sabrina. I got it now. Hey, y'all, we finna get to it. Starlight.
Yes.
Okay, before we went to break, we hit a word. A word that probably caused. I have seen this word called.
We hit a word that probably hit a nerve.
Boy, tear up nerves.
Let's go.
Hey, go. It was a voice in my background, and when you said submissive,
what? You want me to do what? Boy, yeah. You done lost your mind.
You done lost your rabbit.
I see her fix her head.
You done lost your rabbit ass mind.
She turned her head, fixed her head, started smacking a gum.
Hey, boy, that word. Causes a lot. I'm talking about.
You chewing on gum, man. You chewing over there, gum. You chewing hard. It look like it. You probably even got gum in your mouth, but you're chewing. You got some gum like you so white.
I'm good with that word.
Okay. All right, let's go.
The word is submit. I have seen not only black folks, I've seen white folks have problem with this word submit.
Yep. All right.
Submission. Is one Ric Flair used a submission hold the figure four landlord
to get you to
tap out.
Tap out.
Submit.
That's a good one there, Rick. I like that one. Good analogy, Rick.
I get off a good one there, man.
I give you that one, my boy.
Submit in relationships. Well, a lot of time when you hear that, I'm talking about faces get ugly. Faces get ugly. You tear up your lipstick, your mascara, tear it all up. The vibe could be great in the room. You see, heard that word submit. You. Starlight.
Yes.
What is the definition of the word submit?
All right, submit. It is a verb. The first definition: accept or yield to a superior force or to the authority or will of another person.
Ooh.
As in, the original settlers were forced to submit to Belgian rule. Or definition two: submit to a particular process, treatment, or condition.
Oh God! You know what?
Paid all the.
Do we have a better? That superior thing. I sort of can understand why nobody wanted some. I need another way of saying it. Is that a better definition? Like,
what's the hood definition?
Like,
so Urban Dictionary. Hold on.
Yes.
I sort of wouldn't do that either. I sort of wouldn't do that either.
So you got no, you don't want no parts of that.
So maybe might not be the word I want to use ever again then. God night. To superior?
Once again, you plead the fifth.
What about, we got the Bible? We got the Bible terminology?
Hold on, I'm pulling up Urban Dictionary first.
Urban Dictionary.
Mm-hmm.
Do what your man say do.
We don't want the Urban Dictionary definition.
What
this
is say?
Stupid.
Do what the man say do.
It's talking about
BDSM. BDSM.
No.
That's another show. That's not tonight's show. That's a whole other show.
Way down the page, Greg. Like, oh, the first definition.
One, that was the one of the first suggestions.
Greg, what are you on
No.
Greg,
the first definition I saw was talking about submitting work, Greg. And for class.
No.
What you got?
First of all, let's talk about this word.
Let's go. Let's talk about it. Let's talk about what we just heard.
submit.
Okay, ladies, what do y'all feel
when y'all hear the three ladies in the building, when y'all hear the word submit to your man? Because isn't that a vow, a marriage vow? No, it's obey. That's the other word, obey. That's that other word.
But don't we obey each other though, right? Our love and obey is both.
Love and obey. But no, but I think they normally say it to a woman. When they say it in when the
technically the female.
Yes, they say it when they talk to the original. They don't say it when they're talking to the men.
No, the original Victorian vow.
That's a whole nother conversation we ain't got but an hour.
We ain't got but
American. I gotta remember that I say I love and obey.
Was you drunk like everybody else?
No, but I gotta see if I said honor and obey. I gotta go back and look at my vow. Hey, but okay, so women. Okay. So how do y'all?
So we get back to submit, man. So,
oh yeah, my bad. Go ahead. Dang,
you got adult ADD.
I do.
He
does.
I do.
I ain't take my pill.
We discussed this already.
Yeah, I ain't take my pill, y'all. My bad.
You need some wee.
Nah, man, I didn't take my Adderall.
Oh, okay.
All right, so ladies, how do y'all feel about when y'all hear the word submit?
When y'all hear the word submit, what does it do to you?
To me, submission does not necessarily mean weakness.
It does.
There are two different words. Mm-hmm. And if I have my husband is the head of the home, and we're on the same page, submission is not an issue with me because we are on the same accord running our household.
Okay.
So I have no problem with the word submission.
Okay.
And I think a lot of us females, we have a problem with that. And then we're wondering why we're still single.
Mm. Mm. Yeah.
That's the issue.
Mm.
You have got to change the terminology mentally
because
a lot of the new age, quote unquote, I'm every woman, has a negative intonation about submission.
Okay.
But it can't be two head of households.
Okay.
Unless you want to be alone in your household.
You know, I try to say, she said, go ahead, I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
Damn, I'm sorry.
So, like,
don't give me no brown. I know better.
For me, submission is pretty simple. If, like the definition says, if you've come in and I recognize your authority, then I choose to yield to your authority.
Oh.
It's not me saying like, oh, okay, you're taking power over me. No, I'm literally giving you the authority at that point. I'm yielding to you.
So you're the powerful one because you're giving me.
Yes, like I see it, I recognize it. I'm like, okay, you know, cool, I can step back. I'm a single woman.
Yeah.
I gotta take care of stuff. You want to come in and start taking over? Hey, I will step back.
Can I tell you
what? I will step back and do what I need to do.
Let me tell you what. Can I tell you my this is Rick King and my full disclosure. Submission. The word submit. I get why a lot of people are scared because I know a lot of men that abuse the power and abuse the word of submitting.
Mm-hmm.
To me, it's not a scary word because I believe a man, woman in a relationship, both at some particular time submit to each other.
Correct.
Because I'm a person that believes that if my lady is strong in one situation and I'm not as strong in that one, I'm submitting my power 100%. To her to lead the way there.
Yeah.
I got her back. If she has any questions, I'm right here.
Yeah.
But at this moment in time, I need to go ahead because you're the subject matter expert.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
At that particular time.
It's all about trust.
It's about trust. It's about love. It's about vulnerability.
Yeah. You've got to know your role in a relationship.
Oh, exactly. Say that one more time.
You've got to know your role in a relationship.
What's your strong point?
You're talking some things now,
Dana. That is very important. And you have to be secure within yourself in a relationship.
Yes.
And you can't look for someone else to complete you in a relationship. Mm-hmm. There are two parts to a relationship, and both parties have their equal parts in a relationship.
Amen.
And you've got to know your parts in a relationship.
Exactly.
So you have no issue with the word submission when you come together as one in a relationship.
And whoa. I think, I thought I had a sister girl tag in for a moment. And you tagged him to say something or whatever.
And I'm Harold Dennis.
Uh-huh.
And I approve this. <stuff. laughs>
Okay, Harold, you and Sabrina are the only married couple in here.
Mm-hmm.
How do you feel about the word? What when you hear the word what does that do? I mean, am I off base when I say what I just said about submitting?
No, you're not off base. And I would definitely concur with my wife, what she said. And I was going to ask you a question. When she said you have to know your role, one, and then two, is a man weak when he lets the wife oversee the finances?
Oh, hell no. I'm all about trying to do that.
Because
please do that.
Hey, because you have to, like you say, you have to know your role, your strengths, and your weaknesses. Mm-hmm. Because if I'm weak in money.
Absolutely.
Yes, please.
If I'm the man and I'm weak in money, no, I shouldn't be controlling the money.
Right.
Yeah. Because if I'm controlling the money and I'm weak,
yep,
we gonna have some problems.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's why I say I give the role to the subject matter expert.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If you the subject matter expert, baby, please, I got your back. What right. you need me to do?
Right.
And see. Okay.
Because the reason why I said
I
that
like
is
you said about it. Go ahead.
Because, you know, I said that to one of my friends. I was like, well, you know, my wife, she's the CFO. She handles all the money. He's like, oh, man, you're a weak a dude.
What?
I said, well, why am I a weak a dude? He said, because you're letting your wife run the finances. I said, that has nothing to do about that. Oh, your wife's going to take the money and just go buy whatever she wants. First of all, me and my wife, we have an understanding.
Okay? Mm-hmm.
Anything over $500, we consult with each other. Anything under $500, you can buy what you want to buy.
Damn, y'all rich.
Y'all trying to adopt?
I got a $100 limit.
Y'all doing some adoption over there?
Damn, some rich people over here.
Hey, you need to adopt a kid.
Whatever you buy for $500. $499 limit.
I had all the t-shirts and socks.
hey, we gotta, what you call this right here? We gotta omit that part because I don't want no woman dealing with me to be like, so he do 500.
He done set the ball way high.
I know. Like, well, you know what?
Don't be trying to mess up my stuff.
I know. I
try
to mess up your house.
It's okay,
love
Will,
that.
If you can only do
50. Okay. I know. I'm exaggerating. Talking about 100. I'm trying to line on air talking about 100.
Hey, if you honest, it's okay if you can only do 50 before we got to consult.
Good.
It's okay.
Night. But go ahead, Harold. I'm sorry.
So basically, that's the reason why I asked that question. But whatever works in someone else's marriage, let that work in your marriage. Don't try to apply something else to someone else's marriage. You definitely go down the wrong road. But it took a lot of work, a lot of hard work, and a lot of understanding for me and my wife. We just didn't happen overnight. This was some years of in the making. And I always tell people, if you want a happy home, take care of your lawn. Water the grass, you know, cut your lawn, yeah, and you have a green grass.
Yeah, that's true, man. Because, you know, and I'm glad you said that about it. I'm glad y'all brought that up about the finances, because I was going to say that's one thing I know I'm okay with submitting to, especially if I know that she can handle money and she pays bills and she get her credit score is good and all that. I'm great with that, because you can build up and give me an allowance.
Right.
I would give you my check and you just give me an allowance, and I'm good with that.
But that is the conversation that you have to have prior to,
yeah,
exactly,
oh, yeah,
a relationship.
Yes, yes,
and that,
yes,
is the,
yes,
big issue in relationships, because they don't communicate about important,
true,
things.
True.
And those are very important things before you get together.
Very, because finances is a reason.
Absolutely.
One reason why
I think people leave
divorced.
Prior, I mean, finance is probably the number one.
It is.
And
it
adultery
is.
Would be probably the second. People,
yeah,
don't play about that money.
Yeah.
Exactly. You start messing with my money. I've seen a time where you can get away with some adultery.
Yeah. Exactly.
But you didn't say that. So basically, what you're saying is,
yeah,
as long as the money's good, I can have like four or five wives.
Hey. Not when I finish with you. I'm going to make sure you can't afford no 4 or 5 while after I finish with it.
Ain't no Mormons over here. Ain't no Mormon, no polygamous relationship.
Woo! Boy, yes, sir.
So and I think that is the thing. I think a lot of people do get, when they hear the word submission and submit, they do get it's that I'm not weak, I'm not going to bow down to you. I'm not going to just do what you tell me to do. And I don't think that that's what the word submission means.
It does.
And I think people need to take that out of their mindset. And for one thing, women, please do this. Stop listening to your single girlfriends who don't have a man, or the ones who are in a relationship but they're not happy in their relationship. It's probably a reason why all that is about. Mm-hmm. You know, and so stop listening to those people who tell you what you should and what you shouldn't do. Get with some of these women who says it's okay to submit and be submissive, because trust me, your man will submit and he will be submissive too, because you will find that mate.
But you also but you got to talk to the men too.
Yeah,
men, you got to have some good...
You gotta have some conversation
with your boys. You gotta have some men in your life that'll tell you, "Hey, dog, it's okay for you to sit your head down too."
Yeah.
Hey, dog, no, you can't do that, dog.
Yeah.
But dog, I think as a female, I'm sorry, I don't think you can pray for, I need a Lord, send me a good man, send me a husband, and then you have a problem with the word submission.
Exactly.
I mean, you can't have it both ways.
You can't.
Nope.
You can't.
Well, see, most folk that I see pray for a good man or a good woman, they're not ready for it.
What you really want is someone that you can control.
That too.
Or they want somebody that they want. They really want to go get the person they want themselves and hope that it's the right person.
That it's going to be right.
Because I ain't seen a person that pray for a good man, that really pray for a good man, sit back and wait for God to send them that good man.
Absolutely.
Or wait for the universe to send them that good man. Because they go out and do all the wrong things to me to get whomever or whatever that is.
Mm. What's the wrong things? Like, what do you mean?
I mean,
give me some examples of the wrong things that we feel. As men might feel they are the wrong things.
To me, I don't think you can find somebody in the club every night.
Okay.
I don't think you can find somebody on social media every day all the time. Yeah. I don't think you can find somebody running your damn mouth all the time.
Yeah.
I don't think you can find somebody doing dirt all the time.
You sound like you're on the pulpit right now. Come on, brother. Keep going.
That's just me.
Yeah, keep going. You sound like you was on the pulpit. You were preaching that for a minute, brother.
So sometimes you have to me, in order to find whatever it is you're looking for, you got to stand down. You got to sit your head down.
Yeah.
Sometimes you got to you got to find some inner peace with yourself.
Thank you.
You got to find some in you.
Yes.
You got to find some love within you.
Within you.
Because if you don't love you, ain't no way in hell you can love somebody and allow somebody to love you. I'm sorry.
Oh, but you said what you said. Pass the collection, please. What y'all about to sing, Kyle? Turn around and tell the choir to start singing the song, guys.
Like Jay-Z say, put the choir say, I'm sorry.
But I think as some women nowadays, you have a lot of women that make a lot more money than their counterpart or a male in their life, and they consider, well, I don't have to submit because of, well, I make this, or I don't need a man for this, or I don't need a man for that. And we've got to change that way of thinking, because it doesn't align up with what you're saying that you want in your life. It doesn't matter how much you make, or if you make more than your male partner.
You brought up a good point, because you brought up two good points. One is about the amount of money. Like, how many men, and I have to say that about men as well, not just a woman making more money, but how many men are comfortable with their woman making more money than them?
Hey, dog, I hadn't had a serious relationship with a woman, and she has not made more money than me.
Yeah, so you're comfortable with it?
I'm okay with it.
Yeah, I'm perfectly comfortable with it.
I'm okay with it.
I'm comfortable with it.
It doesn't bother me at all.
Okay. Did your wife make more than you? Nah, you're good. Well,
you must have forgot what he said on his whole thing. He let go a certain amount of money to do the share.
I didn't put any finance on that, but the $500 kind of get like, whoa.
Well, when my husband met me, I was the CEO of my own company, so.
Checkmate!
Checkmate!
So we'll leave it at that.
Checkmate!
Touche.
Strange. Good job. Greg, what about you? Are you comfortable with it?
I'm comfortable with it. I never had that situation, but
yeah, would you feel some kind of way if your woman made more than you? Do you think you feel like kind of like
if it was just a matter of she made more than me, but that not if she was using it against me, like right. using
yeah.
it.
Yeah,
trying to emasculate.
Yeah. That's what it would be a problem. As a man.
Yeah.
That's
no, I have had, no, and that's a, that situation there, I have been in that situation.
Yeah.
Who held it over your head? When I was messing with a female, and she had this inheritance money.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And every time she had I had to tell her.
Yeah.
Blank. I don't give a damn about your money.
Yeah.
That is your money.
Yeah.
I'm good.
Tell her.
I'm good.
You'll leave her no matter how much she got.
Bro.
With a stink attitude, don't care about the money.
Bro, money, look here, man. I was born poor. Poor. I'm good with Rick. The best thing I ever did in my life was get good with me.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's it. You got to get that way.
That's the best. And to some people, it was the worst thing that ever happened. Because sometimes when
they didn't need you didn't need them no more. And so their hold over
that's the second point that I wanted to make that she said. Well, that Sabrina said, I'm sorry. Sorry, not
you're fine.
She. But the word need. Mm-hmm. I used to always tell my homeboys and guys that I knew is that the worst thing you can do is let a woman know that she doesn't need you anymore. Mm-hmm. But now I really thought about it. No one needs anybody.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's always I choose to be with you. And when I choose that I no longer want to be with you because of what you no longer bring value to my life, then that's when I let you go. So I had to change up the word need. Mm-hmm. And that's why I sort of shy away from the word saying that we need somebody. A man needs a woman or a woman needs a man. I say that you do probably should have somebody in your life, but that person you have in your life is who you choose mm-hmm. to have in your life, if that makes sense.
I used to say something similar, like I would I used to say, like, you know, I always wanted someone to need me. Yeah. But then I realized when I kept getting used mm-hmm. and I was like, you know what, really, I just need you to want me.
Yes,
I need you to want me. That's that's what's going to be like. If you show me that you want me and I show you that I want you, then we can make the rest of this work. It's like needing is fine, but needing, you get to a point where it's like if you leave then I'm done, or if I leave and you done, and that's two broken people.
Yeah.
Two full whole people are wanted, they're not needed.
Correct. Because I feel that if someone needs you, or you feel like if that person needs you, I always feel like once that person figures out that they don't need you anymore, once they start making their own money,
exactly,
once they start feeling better about themselves or more confident about themselves, then they're going to walk away from you. So that's why I'm like, I don't want anybody to ever feel that they need me. I want to always be a choice.
And the true story with me, when I first met my husband, you know, being a CEO, own company, handling things like handling business in life.
He was a boss.
Baby. I was taking no prisoners. But when I met him, he basically literally told me, look, I don't care how much money you make. Yeah. The minute I can't be the man in your life, I'm gone.
Yes.
And that's I had to do some soul searching.
That's what I'm about.
To do some soul searching and say, wait a minute. Wait.
Did I want this?
Let me think about this.
Yeah.
And it changed my way of thinking, because I had the mentality, hey, I can do this, I don't need, but he gives me a lot more in life than just money.
Amen. I have always felt that if I can't be a compliment in your life,
absolutely,
I don't need to be in your life. I don't want, the best relationships I have ever been in, have been in, is in, she don't need me.
Mm-hmm.
Don't need me.
Oh,
I am a compliment.
Absolutely.
I'm not a necessity in your life.
Yeah.
Because once I become a necessity, we both got problems.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I need you. Well, I don't need you.
Mm-mm.
Oh, boy, that do so. Hey, that might get tangled a little bit. Only
I'll choose you. I want you.
Yeah.
But also in a marriage, though, you can't just be husband and wife. Me and my wife, we're best friends.
Yes.
We can talk about anything. Yes. Sometimes she has to tell me,
hello,
you
really, I'm your wife.
You know, because I tell her about past relationships, what I did and what I've done. And people are like, man, you talk to your wife like that?
Yeah.
Because that's my best friend. At the end of the day, you're going to do what it takes for your best friend.
Now, let me ask you a question.
Amen.
When you said it, did you tell her all that in the beginning? Or did you tell her everything like over the time when y'all got married and all that?
No. Back in the day when I was in my early 20s, I was out there.
Yeah, you were.
And I told her. I says, hey, I'm from Atlanta. This is how it used to be. Yeah. So if we happen to be out and a girl be like, ooh, I know him. Oh. You know, it wouldn't be any problems.
The dreaded, I know. Yeah.
But, and then as our marriage and relationship blossomed, I told her other things.
Yeah.
But I knew she was able to handle that conversation. So she doesn't look at me with a side eye, you know. And I'll say a few things about a particular deaf person, and she just cracks up laughing. But I'll tell you later off the air. You know, but that's my best friend. We can talk about anything. And she can, and the same for her. I mean, if she sees somebody and we're talking, I don't have a problem. I might be like, ooh, she look good, doesn't she? She'll be like, oh, she all right, you know. But but we're best friends.
But that's
good.
That's what you need. That's such a freedom when you, because I have dated a, why you looking? Yeah. Oh my God! Let go, home. Let go.
I can't be disrespectful if y'all don't have that. If y'all don't have that type of relationship now, that could be disrespectful to some women.
But
how you looking though, Rick? Are you watching every bounce of the booty while it's walking away from you, or are you just like okay and then turn away?
At the time, I wasn't even looking at the girl.
Oh, that's insecure. That could be insecurity. Yeah.
But see,
yeah, insecure.
But when you with a woman and she say, damn, man, she fine. She damn sure will, baby.
I don't know.
It's such a... I'm not,
he ain't sucking me in them games no more.
Because that way, you know, hey, you ain't no mess.
I ain't no
sucking. She can be across the room. She can... Hey, and when you look over across the room and y'all catch them eyes, that's all you see in that room. Because all the freedoms has allowed for that romance... Yeah. To kick in. Yeah. Well, y'all see how I tied that in? Boy, y'all hit me on
the
side.
Good timing, bro.
I did that.
Good timing.
Did y'all see how I did
good timing?
He learning.
You like that one short?
No, it was all right.
Six L's
high. So I tied that. I went all the way around and tied, brought that all back.
You want to take a break,
man? You got other people in your audience, man. Don't worry about it.
You want to take a break? We going to take a break. And we come back, we going to talk about some politics, man. We got politics coming up. We will be right back.
You ever see that stuff that be when it get cold, that ice that you can't see? It's after some time. Yeah. Black ice.
Now you know and I know I done bumped every hole in the wall, y'all. Did you catch that phone call? Most of y'all didn't make me. Thought I was tall. Yeah, like a deal. Fell on the black ice. Did you think twice? Home slice came anywhere. Satisfied, got bent balls. Ain't immune coast to coast. Yeah, I left the boat. Man, dose. Too many coming close. Cause touch what I never touched before. Seen what I never seen before. Woke up and seen the sun. Sky high. Sky high. Circulate like a Sunday paper. Papers caught long time. The cheap flicks. Good picks pay hard. Watch the hard turn sideways. Cause tail. For real sales to those with loose cash players. Give your life for now. Feeling good and warm. Windows roll tight. 35 degrees. Nip it at night. Don't forget the chapstick. Lips dry quick. When the jack out, make you wanna act out. Take the slack out. Some people black out.
Touch what I never touched before. Seen what I never seen before. Woke up and seen the sun. Sky high. Sky high. Touch what I never touched before. Seen what I never seen before. Woke up and seen the sun. Sky high. Sky.
I've been in it for the past few days. Tight of the face, I know all my plays. Then can I rap, can I adapt, not really sure yet. Who they looking over the shoulders of those bright dreams? Feeling for the taste of menthol. Miss class, stayed in the hall. Looking for a squeeze play, better yet a holiday. Stayed away from the pyramid board game. Broke it down to a neighborhood slang. Cash before fame.
Sky high, sky high. Sky high, sky high. Sky high, sky high.
Now who done stepped in? B.I.G. the secret weapon. Boy, slicker than black ice. Throw me these flows, I write that wedding. So quick flex. We speaking about something that's refreshing to the earlobes. Pay for the room and still be in pimp mode like iceberg. Chrysler and Buicks. Some on their job so them suckers seem to lose it. Abuse their privileges and now the whole village has been shot to pieces. Like that same stupid, I mean that features. Boy, don't beat me if you ain't got no work. I'm strictly by these verses like the ones you hear at the church, boy. Search, boy. Talking about your dope with song like Lurch, boy. Every time I heard you rhyming like a... jerk boy, friends, romance, countrymen, lend me your eardrums. It was a beautiful day off in the neighborhood.
Yellows and greens and blues and browns and grays and hues that ooze beneath dilapidated wood. Ain't a thing could explain what pertains to cocaine and sustaining rain. See summer rolls around, all about change. Then instead it moved them keys like Bob James. Cause old man winter's arrived, the temperature dies. November just died, December's alive. Thus it ain't no typical ride. Just individuals way to bring home the bacon when bacon was all wrong. Making it our own, taking me all wrong. We've all indulged in the bulge of those. No, 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 you ain't so low. That's even lower level you can go. Take sun people, put them in the land of snow.
Touch what I never touched before. Seen what I never seen before. Woke up and seen the sun. Sky high, sky high. Touch what I never touched before. Seen what I never seen before. Woke up and seen the sun. Sky high, sky high. Touch what I never touched before. Seen what I never seen before. Woke up and seen the sun. Sky high, sky high. Touch what I never touched before.
Damn. Welcome black, welcome black, welcome black, welcome George. Black to Barbershop Talking Random Ish with
George
your
got
boys,
any kids?
King and Sane. I am Rick Kane.
I am Will Sane.
I am the lovely Starlight.
Hey, hold on, hold on. Hey, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on.
He got stumped with a trivia.
Yeah.
You gotta let that go.
Hey, we got Mr. Hal Dennis, Sheriff-elect of DeKalb County in the house.
Sheriff candidate
of DeKalb County in the house. I don't know, my bad.
But that's all right. We're going to go with
yeah. We got his lovely, lovely wife, Sabrina, in the house.
Yes,
indeed.
And now we got Mr. I'm terrible. I just said your name. Mr. Dargan in the house as well. Welcome aboard, sir. Now he just stumped me with a question. That's
why
I'm stumbling.
Put the question on there. Put the question on there. Can you put it on there?
I just got a $20 challenge. And it was
named
three white men with the last name Washington.
George.
That I know.
George.
I'm stuck on George. I know. That's what I was about to say. I don't even know George.
I read about him. Read about him.
What happened to white men with Washington last name? Did they die out? What happened? Did they change their
name? That's a good one.
Did they get extinct?
Don't know.
That's a good one.
That is the blackest.
It did change to the blackest name.
Hold on, so Jones and
Muhammad.
Okay, please give him the mic.
What's the most popular last name?
Lee.
Smith.
Yeah, I think it is Smith. I think it is Smith.
I know Muhammad Sheldon told us that.
Yeah, but Muhammad's because it runs in the Eastern world. And there's a whole lot more of them than we have.
Yeah, I think that's why that.
Yeah, Muhammad, and Sheldon told us
but
that.
But what happened to white Washingtons?
He's still
so Jones ain't the black.
Hey, we got to do a search for the white Washingtons.
There's some logic behind it.
Is it?
Yes, there is.
What is it? Can you explain?
After
come to the mic.
Yeah, come to the mic, please. School me on this one.
After slavery.
Yeah.
Most black people that were enslaved, mm-hmm. as distinguished from being slaves, only had a first name.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And if they had a last name, more than likely it was Massa's last name.
Correct.
So they said, I want a very dignified, respected last name.
Mm-hmm.
George Washington, president of a country.
Yeah.
Thomas Jefferson.
Yeah, a lot of black Jefferson.
Ben Franklin.
But see, there's a lot of black Jeffersons Jackson. Because Jefferson was in Mama.
Wait a minute.
Those are the most.
No. But do you? No. But he's right because I don't know any. Do you know any white Jeffersons? Like, I don't know a damn white Jefferson. Like, no, not
was
one.
Was it their receiver?
Like, I might find a Washington.
That was a Jefferson. A white.
Jefferson.
It wouldn't. Oh, okay.
Now, who was the first black president?
That was
he's somebody told
me
on the back of the $2 bill.
I saw that he was a black.
He's on the back of the $2 bill, but I forgot his name.
So there's a black man on a $2 bill.
Yes, it is
on the back.
On the back.
Interesting. You ever seen a black man on a $100 bill?
No.
Harold.
Technically.
Yeah, it's one.
Who?
If you count the
Jefferson, the 30 seconds rule.
Who's on the $100 bill? Franklin. If you count the 30 seconds rule.
Why he 30 seconds removed from black?
No, all you need is a drop.
What do you mean I need a drop?
All you need is a drop of blood to be considered.
Are you handing these out?
Black like take home $100 bill.
Hey, you didn't give me that.
Are these take homes?
Hey, yes, sir.
He's got them.
Oh, I thought it was a whole one.
I'm like, dude, you feel how thin it is? She's like, if you count the 30 seconds rule.
You know, women, they know money.
You can always tell a Morehouse man.
You can't hold
but
me.
You can't tell him nothing. My daddy was one. I'm sorry. You can't tell him nothing.
Hey, I'm gonna go to Magic City and just start throwing these on the floor. Let's see what happens when I walk out later on that night.
You're telling on yourself now.
Everybody down to go to Magic City?
Oh, God.
I didn't put the question out there. We finna go talk politics.
Is the kitchen open?
Oh yes. Hey, I want me some of them.
Man, that kitchen is amazing.
I want some of them them Lou wings.
But in lieu of the $20 that you owe me.
Who's this?
In lieu of the $20 that you owe me.
I never bet that I return $20 if I can't answer. You asked me if I want to earn $20. I thought at first you were talking about me doing some male prostitution. So I said no. I got scared at first.
But in lieu of the $20,
what's that?
I want you to Cash App $18.67.
$18.67.
Harold Dennis 2020.
Gotcha.
Do it right now.
Gotcha.
Do it right now.
Oh, well, see, the way my bank account and my check is set up.
You got a checking and a savings, but you got to move from the savings to the checking, and you got to move.
Somebody in here knows right now that my Cash App and my bank account ain't set up right, that I had to give them cash hard money. So give you cash hard 1867.
Speaking of Harold Dennis, Tuesday
early
is the
voting.
First. It starts early vote.
Early voting.
Technically speaking, that's why you here.
Okay.
At 8:30, we were supposed to be coming in here. We were gonna ask. Hold up. We still ain't got to. We gonna get to your uncle questioning. We gonna get to aunt questioning in the end. But we gonna talk. Boy, y'all, black folks in the Bible. You can't let black folks just in the Bible so they can be talking about anything they want to talk about. It's no conversation.
Let me cut off one minute. I'm sorry. I just realized what this is. This is a dope business call.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
This is a dope business call.
Yes, it is.
I just realized what it was. Yes. I had to cut you off.
I don't sit here and look at my
This is a dope business call.
Even Malcolm X over there.
That's his daddy.
That's dope.
That's his daddy.
Hey, man, I got to give you a damn on that. You're a businessman. God night.
Okay.
All right, that's good to have.
The show originally was supposed, hey, we supposed to be coming in here because early vote started on Tuesday. Mm-hmm. And the Cobb County Sheriff candidate, Harold Dennis, it's family. And I was supposed to been bringing him in here to talk about why we need to get out and vote. We going to vote. We're going to vote. Why we need to vote for
we
him.
Got, we got time. We got 20 minutes. Let's do it.
Why we need to vote for you, Harold?
You need to vote for me for DeKalb County is because I want to make that positive change for DeKalb County citizens. Not just the citizens, but also the inmates that are currently incarcerated at DeKalb County Sheriff's Office. Have a second chance job program that I'm initiating once I'm elected sheriff. For those individuals who've been incarcerated at DeKalb County, working with several businesses that's willing to work with me once they've been released, where they can go out and have a great job making $16, $17, and $18 an hour so they can support their family. So we can stop the recidivism of having inmates going in and out of the jail system. The only way we're going to break that cycle is someone believes in them and give them a chance to go out and be the real man or to be the real woman that they want to be able to support their families.
Yep. You might get on.
Y'all see how he tied it all in? Well, we just tied him in tonight. Y'all act like y'all in the radio, man.
Now, question for you. Can you tell us, can you list some off the top of your head, some deficiencies in DeKalb County currently that you feel that you can fix, like in your first 100 days?
First 100 days, certainly. First of all, the main one is the contracts that are being utilized right now at the sheriff's office. It's a lot of corruption going on with the contracts, the bedding contract, the medical contract, and you have certain people benefiting from these contracts that are lining their pockets. So once I swear in as the sheriff of DeKalb County, the first order of business is to contact the FBI and the GBI and do a full forensic audit to come in and get those contracts and get these people out of the pockets of the taxpayers. That money belongs to you, the taxpayers.
Yeah.
Second, reaching out to the bail bonding companies that are still operating in DeKalb County that are deficient in their monies. They owe DeKalb County taxpayers the FAFES, and that's money for bodies that they did not retrieve.
Oh, really?
We need the, yes, when you have bonding companies owing the county over $300,000, why are you still allowing that company to operate? Yeah. Well, they're operating because they're giving the current sheriff that's in office now $30,000 towards her campaign to keep her in office, to keep these contracts rolling.
Get out of here, man. That's one of the things I always looked at was the bail bonding companies. I've been arrested before, and that's what actually the sheriff was riding around with the bail bondsman in the car with him. Mm-hmm. And I feel that was kind of like, what's the word? I always mess up that word.
Conflict
of interest. Oh, yeah. I don't know why I always messed that up. But yeah, I always felt that was a conflict of interest. So you're looking at, all right, cracking down on some of these bail bonding companies that actually owe money.
That money is owed to the taxpayers of the county.
I'd like to hear that.
One Carl. Carl is a family.
True.
Carl Mobley, he was also running on this ticket with you. But one of his things was being able to have the sheriff respond to some of the 911
calls.
So that they can make to cut down on some of the wait in response time. Response time. That's the word I was looking for.
The response time.
How do you feel about that? And you also talk about the phone calls coming out the jail.
Yes.
Certainly. Yeah, I think that's a big thing.
Well, Carl and I, we both spoke, and I said this also in 2016, that we would have DeKalb County Sheriff's Office help respond to 911 calls to help DeKalb Police. Currently, they're understaffed by 300 officers, so they do need some help. They do need some backup to help answer some of these calls that are being generated at DeKalb, so we can cut down on the response times. Also, I stated early on an earlier show that the phone calls that the inmates make, you know, if you're incarcerated, it's first of all, it's already a struggle on your family that you're incarcerated for money-wise. So you don't need to be paying, you know, high rates making collect phone calls to your family members driving their bills sky high. So I have a program that I would initiate free phone calls for the inmates to be able to call and talk to their loved ones.
I think that's a big deal. That's a real big deal. Now, about with the 911 calls and the sheriff's department helping to respond, do you think that would be a welcome change to the actual sheriff department as well?
Certainly. The deputies are looking forward to that.
Okay, yeah.
You went to the police academy, you're a police officer, you know, you're a deputy sheriff. So, yes, you can get out there and answer 911 calls. Our main primary purpose for the sheriff's office is to maintain the security of the courts, also maintain the security of the jail, and serve the papers of the court, which is i.e. the warrants and civil papers. But if, like I stated earlier, if you just drive right down past Stonecrest Mall, you have Rockdale County. They're a full-fledged sheriff's office. They also handle all the 911 calls in Rockdale. The city of Conyers is only so big, but Rockdale County handles the whole county. So we can certainly get out there and help and the DeKalb Police and back them up and get out and answer some of these 911 calls.
Yep. That's good, because you're right about Rockdale County. I see those guys out there all the time. Good gosh.
You did.
And then also, who else is willing to give up $100,000 of their salary to give raises to the deputies who haven't had a raise in 8 years?
That's what I'm talking about. Man of the people. Man of the people. And you're taking a pay cut in this.
Taking a pay cut, and I'm still willing to give up $100,000 of my salary.
And you're willing to be a guest on our show.
Certainly. And I said, once I'm elected... You know, once I'm elected, the show that I'd like to say is, you know, let's ask the sheriff. You can get to call in and talk to the sheriff.
That's what I'm talking about.
I'm finna lock this in right now. If you're elected, what day will you be taking office?
So once I'm elected, November the 3rd, I'll take office January 1.
January 1, so at the stroke of midnight. Days, 100 days after January 1 would be April 1st?
April 1st.
So that Friday... The first Friday in April, that means we need you in the barbershop because we need a report card on the first 100 days of you and us.
Certainly. And you would get that.
It's about March 15th.
It's about March 14th, 15th.
I was on.
No.
I was off a whole bunch of day.
April 10th.
See, y'all, y'all act like I can't count.
Who's doing this math in here? Who got this?
It's April 10th.
It's well, April 10th.
You got the CPA over there, so you know he keeps up with
it. I know. You know what every day. What day is the 23rd of April? What day is that?
It's going to cost you $18.67. Cash out to...
Cash App kind of down.
Gonna ring your bill up.
Hey, Cash App got me on freeze.
Sabrina.
I think I got $10 in the Cash App right now.
Your husband is trying to become a public servant. That means y'all life is open. How do you feel about that?
Well, for me, I support my husband in his endeavors. I mean, this has been... years, he has always said, well, he wanted to help the county. Mm-hmm. And let's just put on the record, I'm giving up my flight benefits as well for the Cab County.
I didn't want to say that.
So, of course, I support
him. That's what we talked about before. I didn't want to say that.
So, that's a big sacrifice on my end. But he has, everything he sets out to do, he does it. And yeah. He set out, you know, he was a police officer, paid his way through flight school, which was not cheap. Mm-hmm. Became a commercial pilot. So everything he sets his mind out to do, he achieves. And I back him 100%.
That's what I'm talking about.
Hey, man, you can't lose.
Yeah, man.
You can't lose.
I mean, yeah, you can't.
With
the Cab County got to get out of here.
The Cab County can't lose because...
And vote for the right person.
This thing here... It's goals.
Mm-hmm.
Relationship goals.
Mm-hmm.
I mean... And like I say, I know we all on camera, we really, and it's a, but you feel something genuine about what y'all have.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
This your second time running it?
Third. This is my third.
It's
so funny.
Why?
It's almost deja vu.
Why in the hell would you put yourself through this numerous of times? Why?
Because God placed something on my heart to do something for the citizens.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just stand up and do the right thing. When you have officers out there, you know, brutalizing neighborhoods and Black Lives Matter in particular, it's funny how people say, well, become a police officer and you can change your community. Well, one or two police officers can only change a couple of blocks, but imagine the head sheriff, I can change the whole county.
Yeah, with that relationship and everything, getting out there with the people.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm talking about. Now, how do you see, because I always look at, I'm that person who, I'm trying to be less judgmental because I am very judgmental. I realized the difference between judgmental and opinionated a few days ago.
When did you figure that? A few days ago.
A friend of mine told me that I'm very judgmental, and I was like, I didn't know the difference, but now I know the difference.
Okay.
But how do you get it to where, how do you feel like you can entice, and that's for a lack of a better word,
mm-hmm.
how do you feel you can entice the people in the community to come out to support the sheriff department
mm-hmm.
once you get into office? Because I feel that, and I think a lot of us feel that our people, mm-hmm. Black people, we do have that fear
mm-hmm.
of working hand to hand with the sheriffs
mm-hmm.
or
no.
law enforcement.
Before you answer that
question. No, you don't stop my question. No, I asked a question.
You did.
Let him answer that first. Then you come with your go ahead.
Question. No.
You can't piggyback off a question.
No, I'm intertwining this question. We got young people. We have people who hate the police, still hate the police.
Mm-hmm.
Now, answer his question,
mm-hmm.
because you got to reach some of our youth who don't like the police.
Mm-hmm.
No. What the hell? You got to answer some 48-year-old people who don't like the police. Mm-hmm. I'm that person.
I like the police.
I'm scared.
Now, let me answer my question.
But go ahead. Answer the question. Yes.
First of all, you have to build honesty, integrity. And then trust. So that's been lost over the years that's going on right now, as you can see that's being played across America and just right here in DeKalb County. But and the way to do that is to start first interact with the Citizen Review Board, and that's something that it would be new.
Yeah.
I know you've heard a few people saying that, oh yeah, let's do a Citizen Review Board, but they haven't done it.
Yeah.
I'm serious about starting and initiating the Citizen Review Board, and that's taking different members throughout the county from Registered Homeowners Association through DeKalb County, bring these people on board to sit with my staff and review use of force reports, We would also review the budget of the sheriff's office and how we utilize the budget, because there again, that money belongs to you, the taxpayers.
Correct.
So when we bring the citizens in and sit down, and we can all come together and collaboratively make a great group and decide the next steps that we need to do at the sheriff's office, then you'll gain that honesty and that integrity. And then also just being transparent. People like that when they're transparent. So when you have an officer has a use of force report, and you know how they says, well, are you going to release the body cam footage? And they don't want to do that because they think you're trying to hide something. Well, mm-hmm. if you have a citizen review board, they get the review and says, yes, we'll go ahead and put this out. Mm-hmm. And certainly we'll go ahead and put it out. So that way people won't speculate. You know, when you're hiding something, then a lot of the mind start to wonder as what's going on. So yes, that's why I definitely want to bring that transparency.
I like that. And I do, and I think that will work. I think that would actually help, would help a lot of us feel more comfortable mm-hmm. with. Now, Rick, you had a question or you're on the phone? What was your question going to be?
We got a question coming in. Go okay. ahead. Ask a question.
Oh, so me or the person on the phone? Oh, okay. So my other question was going to be following up with the Citizen Review Board and all that. How do you get, how do we, and I guess it still goes along with that same question. We have a big problem in the black community. And I hate the term black community. But we have a big problem in the black community when it says don't snitch.
Mm-hmm.
And so we have a lot of kids and a lot of crime that don't go reported.
Mm-hmm.
How can you get those people to, once again, this may be the same question, just asked a different way.
Mm-hmm.
How can you get those people to come forward to start talking to you guys about, okay, reporting these crimes that are really plaguing our community?
That's easy. We're going to put a program that was instilled back when myself and Rick was in our teens, going to Columbia and Towers High School. We had the COPS program,
mm-hmm.
and that's involving cops to come back and be in your community.
Okay.
Community involvement. So when you can trust that officer that you know, that's a real cool dude, and they got your back no matter what. If you snitch, they're not going to snitch you out. They're not going to say, hey, well, this is my confidential informant. No. It's people right now that still feel comfortable talking to me in the hood.
Yeah.
They'd be like, no, I don't mess with anybody else. I want to talk to him because I know he's fair.
Yeah.
I know him. He's giving me a break.
Yeah.
Being a police officer, I love it. You don't have to always lock up everyone to enforce the law.
Mm-hmm.
You can give warnings. You mm-hmm. can give breaks. That's still enforcing the law. And people remember it. They'll remember that.
Somebody just walked in the barbershop. What you need? What you want?
Yo, Will Starlight.
What's hey, good?
Girl, Sabrina. I like what you said a little ways back, Harold, when you said we have an agreement. If it's more than $500, if it's less than $500, then you can do what you want with it. But it's we have an agreement. That implies team.
Mm-hmm.
But I got a question.
Yes, sir.
As far as it goes to the citizens, as far as it applies to the Citizens Review Board, do you want them to have the power to subpoena, and do you want them to have the power to vote out an officer?
Well, they can definitely have the power to subpoena. But we will take their recommendation. What comes up as far as disciplinary action, that will still have to be handled by the top level staff, but they will be working so closely with them. It's hand in hand like a team. So they can say, well, you know, we recommend that this officer, you know, that you terminate this officer. And so they're sitting with the top level staff and they all come together and vote and says, hey, okay, yes, we do believe that. Then that's what would happen. That's the only way that's going to build trust and integrity. Back into the sheriff's office and the community.
You think the budget needs to be adjusted?
Of course.
Department?
Well, let's say this. Let's not get into let's defund the police, because you start defunding the police, then now.
Oh, no. I'm not in that group.
Yeah, okay. Good.
Definitely.
Yeah, I'm not in that. I'm not in that group either.
But
keep Walton County Police alive. Funded well. I pay extra taxes to keep
this. Okay, my question is, hold on.
But
I might,
go ahead.
Hold on. Let's talk about do we have time to talk about the whole Dufon thing?
Yes.
Do we have time?
Oh, I don't know. I gotta get ready to get out of here. Y'all can have it without me. I gotta run. I got something. I got a little man. I'm on daddy duty.
Oh, okay.
I'm on daddy duty.
Okay. Well, my definition of defund the police and everything I've seen about defunding the police is mm-hmm. not taking all the money out of the police station.
Mm-hmm.
It's not stripping the police station out of all of theirs. There's a lot of money that going into the police station that seems like it's not necessary.
Such as,
I mean, don't make me.
See, that's me personally.
Are you speaking to the mismanagement of the funds?
Yeah, I think it's mismanagement because I think the money is necessary. Mm-hmm. I just think that people use it the wrong way.
Okay. And there's a lot of defund when we holla defund. They defund the money for the school systems all the time.
They shouldn't though.
And do you see what's happening to the school system?
Exactly. No. I'm so against it.
Not the best thing to do.
So I'm saying I'm never for getting rid of the police station.
Mm-hmm.
Getting rid of the police force. But if there's some money in the police for in
but that's adjusting a budget.
Use that money wisely, see, I say. Don't take the money. Use it wisely.
But that's where you should adjust the budget.
Is that what they mean? Is that the real definition of defund?
No. Defund is take that money from them and use it somewhere else.
It no longer goes to you.
Yeah.
That's what happened with education.
Yes.
They let it fall under the term of we will defund education because people were talking about there was frauding in it. And instead of fixing the education budget, they just took the money away.
Pay the officers more, or either doggone use it to get more officers, or use it for training for them.
Okay,
use it that way or something. Don't buy more projectors. Don't buy more tanks that you probably never going
to
need.
That's what I'm talking about. Is it necessary to have the tanks?
Don't take the money. Just put the money somewhere else within still in the police or the force to me. Because when I look at all these officers out here who are saying that they're underpaid, and I can agree that they're underpaid,
I can definitely
then don't buy the tank, but use the money for the person. But don't take the money from the organization and put it into, okay, now I'm going to go.
How about education?
You know what I say? Okay, I gotta get out of here. But I'm gonna say this because I gotta see your sprinter van. I gotta go take a field trip.
We all gotta see the sprinter van.
But what I'm saying is this right here. Even with like education and all these other things that we take the money from, I say personally, me, keep the money in the police. Keep the money with the education. What I say, you have to take money from, and people don't like it. You might have to take it from government assistance to me more so than anything else.
Yes.
Because some things, my thing is like, people, as long as I keep giving you stuff, you're not going to ever get up on your own or try to get up on your own to become what you possibly can be.
But that system itself needs to be redone.
That I do.
That system needs to be redone.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, let me tell you my only rebuttal to that.
Okay.
2020 Rona.
That's
a different circumstance.
Okay, no, that's different though, Rick. Yeah. With 2020 Rona kick in, use some money that way
But if the systems were done we wouldn't have had to scramble as a country once this happened. If the systems were done right, we would not have had to scramble, and it wouldn't have been such of a hard thing because that would have been a pocket. There would have been.
We'll be
top of the album.
Y'all.
We gotta take a quick break.
We gotta take a quick break, people.
Greg, come on.
You are tuned into WWE Lakeville, AM 1100.
The opinions expressed during the sponsored programs on this station are strictly those of the program hosts, guests, and callers, and are not necessarily those of Beasley Broadcast Group, this station, its staff, other advertisers, or agencies.
I know I may be young, but I've got feelings too, and I need to do what I feel like doing, so let me go and just listen. All you people look at me like I'm a little girl. Well, did you ever think it'd be okay for me to step into this world?
Okay. Okay.
Are we going to do the question at all?
We back on air. And yes, we are.
Okay.
We are backs on air. No, we going to ask the question. But we are back. We got Harold, Dennis, DeKalb County Sheriff Department, nominee, a Twinkie 2020 in the building. We have his lovely wife. We have his lovely wife, Sabrina, in the building. The lovely Starlight has took. Will's seat. How the hell I forget Will, man? took Will's seat. We got Big Shook still in the building doing his thing. I can't get a hug.
I had to do it for him. He stepped out for a second.
But no, we've just tying it up right quick. Tell them how to donate to your campaign. Tell them what we need to do to get you in office.
Certainly. If you really like to help, I definitely need some volunteers to get out to help me put out yard signs. We have 1,000 yard signs we got to get out between now and November 3rd. And I would like to try to get them out like before November 15th, October 15th, to get these signs out. And also go with me in the shopping centers to shake hands with the people because I work for the people. I don't work for myself. I work for the citizens of the county. So definitely get out. I need some volunteers for that. But you can also contact me via my cell phone, which is 404-590-6269.
And he for real answered the phone.
Yes.
Yeah, certainly. Certainly. I was surprised. He answered the phone for you.
Certainly. Once again, 404-590-6269. And you can also email me at hdennis4sheriff@gmail.com. And you can also go to the website. If you're not registered to vote, I think it's too late to register to vote. But if you don't know your polling place, you can also go to my website, which is haroldennisforsheriff.com. And there's a tab where you can go and it can show you your voting precinct if you don't know where to go.
For sure. This has been an amazing. I don't do politics. It's two things I really don't do, religion and politics. Mm-hmm. Because I think they are the biggest separator of my people. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But I have learned. So learned is hoodish. I bet you can find it in that hood dish in there. I have learned so much. Starting with Carl. Mm-hmm. You, which to me is great, mm-hmm. because I'm a person that I want to continue to learn. I think if you're not learning, you're dying. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And the greatest thing about the relationship between you and Carl, y'all are on separate ends of the game. Mm-hmm. You, to me, a great man of integrity. You're a great man of faith. All these cliches that you hear all these people talk about when they start talking about these people. Mm-hmm. I can't believe I'm saying this. To me, you are that. I hope for the people of DeKalb County that you get this. I am here to support you so that you can get this. Mm-hmm. I want you to know that Rick King of Talking Random Mission, and I believe I'm speaking for Talking Random Mission when I say this, we support you. So if you need us, if you need somebody to come help do something, I can shake some hands. I almost said I can shake some babies.
No, you kiss the babies and you shake the hands.
I can do some of that, but you could not have told me a year ago I'd be this deep
in
politics. Mm-hmm. Because I absolutely hate politics. Mm-hmm. But I know it is so necessary, and these local elections are the most necessary.
Important. They're the most important.
Because when you vote for your president and your senators, that's on a federal level. So it doesn't really affect you their first term. It really normally affects you about their second term,
mm-hmm.
which is 8 years later. Your local election, you're putting in your sheriff. You're putting in your district attorney. You're putting in your solicitor general. You know, you need to know in your state legislatures. Mm-hmm. You need to know if a law is on the books that is so old that needs to be changed. That's your state legislatures. Mm-hmm. But people don't understand that. That affects you immediately.
Thank you.
Yeah. Sir.
Thank you.
Once again, I'd like to thank, you know, your family, the Random Talking-ish family, you know, your lovely co-host, your sound guy, yourself, Will. I truly, from the bottom of my heart, thank you guys for allowing me to come and speak. Like I tell people, it's not about being a Democrat. It's not about being a Republican when it comes to the sheriff's race, because the sheriff is for all people.
Mm-hmm.
It needs to be nonpartisan. Because I can't pull you over and say, oh, you're a Democrat. Oh, Starlight, you're going to jail, beautiful. I'm sorry, you're a Democrat. It does not work that way. I will build economic development in DeKalb County by making my county safe. Where crime dies, a city thrives. Remember that.
Go on, Real. got your Jesse on there. Hey, we got one quick question before we get up out of here. Starlight's uncle.
Yeah.
Yes, I called you uncle because you now you my uncle too. He had a question. What is the question that uncle had? And first of all, thank you, uncle, for listening.
His question was this: why does it seem like that the mainstream media has somehow gotten to the point where they're just talking heads, but it's not no longer connected at all to their audience, where it's like you being a part of the audience, you're reading or you're hearing things, and it's just like it's almost like you're reading an alien language or hearing an alien language, where it's like, okay, you don't even know anything about any of the sides that you're talking about. So it even goes beyond like reporter bias, mm-hmm. where it's just like they're so journalistic that they just miss it. And he kind of was just asking me if we can kind of just throw it out there to, you know, our panel tonight and just even our listening family, why do you think that happened, or where did it happen, or kind of just do you even feel like that if you're listening to the media?
I do. It's to the news, it's not news if no one wants to listen. So mm-hmm. they're going to do what they want with the news media. And the reason why I say that is because my wife always says, well, you know, go get on the news and talk. Well, the news have a way of playing people, because they'll just take a soundbite what you mm-hmm. said to something totally different,
mm-hmm.
and they'll make you look bad. So you have to be kind of careful of who wants to interview on the news. There are some great reporters out there. One, Nicole Carr from Channel 2. I like Nicole because she's trustworthy, and she stands for integrity, and she also stands for transparency. She asked a question to me back in 2016 when I ran against Jeff Mann. Of course, you know, he went to jail mm-hmm. for through Piedmont Park. And I love Rick.
You weren't supposed to laugh.
But,
I'm so sorry.
You know, she asked a question, and she said, you know, I want to ask you something off the record. And I said, certainly. And she said, well, I understand that you were also arrested for a public indecency, but it was dismissed and expunged.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to talk about it? I said, sure. I told her, I said, I was sitting in a vehicle with a young lady. A zealous officer pulls up, a report was written, and the case was dismissed and expunged. There was no public indecency in reference to the whole case. And she said, you know what? I like you because you're honest. I could have said, I don't know what you're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
But she wanted to see and ask me personally if I was honest. And I'm an honest person.
Exactly.
Now, I would. I believe that all the news, the separate news entities, which means non-biased, objective or subjective. I meant to look it up before, but I'm transparent.
I would think objectivity is more closer.
Mm-hmm. No news right now in this day and age. I don't believe there's that none of the news systems that we have mm-hmm. are objective. Mm-hmm. I think they do cater to their audience mm-hmm. because their audience is all they care about. So they are going to put out I know people who watch Fox News one segment and they watch CNN another mm-hmm. segment so they can get both sides. Mm-hmm. That's telling me that these people are so subjective in their news mm-hmm. reporting that they are only catering to their audience. They really don't make room to get other on the fence type people to become new fans because they only care about who they're serving. Mm-hmm. I don't know if that has a lot to do with now that social media, a lot of these media outlets are owned by big corporations now. And big corporations are political. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if that has a lot to do with it. But to me, I think a lot of these, they do cater to their audience because they only spinning it one way and the people that they have to come on that is against their opinion are so safe. Mm-hmm. It's really not going to rock the boat.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm glad you said, like, prime example. I'm not making anything up. This is actual truth. There's paperwork that's out there. The current sheriff that's in his office now, she's behind like $230,000 in debt. How can you be behind $230,000 in debt and your check is being garnished, but you're going to be over making a $98.6 million budget? What? But the news don't want to put it out there. Because they're saying, well, she's in an election. We don't want that to come up and perhaps damage her reputation as far as running. But if that's the truth, the people need to know that. Because you're handling my taxpayer dollars. $98.6 million, that's a lot of money. Mm-hmm. So if you can't handle your own bills and you're behind $230,000 in debt and they're garnishing your check, how can you serve the people?
Mm-hmm. I think, ain't that the same question on the guy that's presently running?
Yeah.
Like those same questions about $4 million that he owns. I'm just saying,
But it's very similar, just the thoughts I've had, just in, of course, with all the millions and millions of run commercials for all of the people that are running elections, no real citizen who wants to know their information should have to do Google searches where mm-hmm. you're on like two or three pages down mm-hmm. trying to find the real speech mm-hmm. that this one little second soundbite came mm-hmm. from mm-hmm. that you spliced together to mean something to realize like, oh, well, yeah, they said that, but it was said in this frame of mind to these people because of this, because of that. Like, I shouldn't. The news shouldn't have gotten to a point where we're so soundbite and headline to the point where you're having
get clicks.
And it's not it's even
clickbait.
That. It's
everything
like,
is clickbait.
The clickbait mm-hmm. now is so horrible. Mm-hmm. Like, you literally will have something about a person doing a great thing, but then you'll be like, did they really drop the baby? And it's just like, wait, what? That has mm-hmm. nothing to do mm-hmm. with this at all. What you're really talking about.
It's so bad. After the first comedy show on CNN, not the other night, but the first comedy show that was on CNN, I watched the talk after. I first watched it on CNN, and then I turned to Fox. And to hear these are the same exact comedy show. Mm-hmm. It was so unreal that the two separate points, I mean, they were so far off. Mm-hmm. It shows you how they are so subjective. That mm-hmm. shows you their mm-hmm. opinion. That shows mm-hmm. you it's who very biased. Running their. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So how and maybe how do can we even get things back to, because news is supposed to be objective. Mm-hmm. It's supposed to be us. It's supposed to be facts. Be. It's yeah. supposed to be get the facts, facts, explain no the opinions. Facts, give you the facts, no yep. opinion.
Exactly.
How do we get back to that?
I don't know. And that was actually why my uncle brought up the question, because he was saying that he appreciates shows like ours, because we do come with different opinions, but we try our best to bring facts, bring truth, even if it goes against our opinions about things, we still try to put it out there for our listeners. Because, like you said, we being a part of the media, we owe it to our listeners to give facts. It's not about, like, yes, we'll give opinions on stories, but if it's something like politics or things that affect people, then it's like they need to know the truth. They need to know what's all out there.
And see, and that's why, I said it, and I'm going to say it till I can't say it. I hope this be on my tombstone. Even though I want to be on the football field, but that's a whole different But I hope it be on my tombstone.
We'll put a plaque on the field.
That the reason why this show is called Talking Randomish Barbershop Style Conversation is because I think the barbershop is the heart of the community. And the barbershop is where we can come and get all the information. Mm-hmm. We get all walks of life in this barbershop. Mm-hmm. You're going to get some. We ain't on air, we grit. Well, you can get some bullshit, but you're going to get some of the truth in the barbershop, because you're going to get all kind of people in here. Mm. I never would have thought I would have a conversation with a black Republican. Mm-hmm. I never would have thought that me and a black Republican would have any
see eye to eye
on anything. Mm-hmm. Because of my conditions.
You gotta look past the symbols and look at the mm-hmm. person.
Why? When you go to Switzerland in all colors of, but that's why I love this. That's why I love what we do. That's why I love you. I love Greg, my new family, Harold. Because we can have these conversations. Mm-hmm. And Greg and Harold, let me tell you something funny. Remember the first night I kept asking you who are you?
Right.
I think we learned who you are tonight. Thank you, Sabrina.
Thank you.
You are a beautiful, loving, supportive wife to this man.
Yes.
You are a can't say beautiful because you ain't beautiful. The love that I seen in the way you talk about her mm-hmm. is beautiful. Thank y'all for blessing Talking Randomish with your presence.
Thank you.
I don't care what happens. November the 3rd, even though I know we going to put you in office, and I'm going to have you on April 10th.
Roughly.
I think that's 100 days.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to have you back here, and then after that, we're going to have subsequent shows. You have something that we need to be part of.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to be part of something. Thank y'all. Thank you, Greg. Big Shug, for all you do. I want to thank the lovely Starlight for all you do.
Thank you.
Real same, my brother, thank you. I still need my $100. Hey, y'all know what time it is. It's about time to sweep the flow.
Yeah.
We going to clean the Clippers. Said that man ain't gave me my $100. You got the bathroom. The shop is closed.